Welcome you all for class 8 subject science. So today we are going to continue with our topic, that is chemical effects of electric current. So now here we are going to learn about electroplating. What is the meaning and all, how it is being done? You know that a brand new cycle has shiny handle, bar and wheel rims, yes or no? However, if these are accidentally scratched, the shiny coating comes off, revealing a not a so shiny surface beneath. You might have also seen women using ornaments, jewelries we use, which appear to be made of gold. However, with repeated use, the gold coating wears off, revealing silver or some other metal beneath. Means it looks shiny gold only for few days. After few days, it becomes dull and what is there inside, it comes out. That is, in both the cases, a metal has been coated of another metal. Means inside is one metal, the outside the other metal can be seen. Do you wonder how a layer of one metal can deposit two on the top of another? Okay, well, now let us see here now. First, in the activity, we will need copper sulfate and two copper plates of size around 10 cm and into 4 cm. Take about 250 ml of distilled water in a clean and dry beaker. Dissolve 2 teaspoonful of copper sulfate in it. Add few drops of dilute sulfuric acid to copper sulfate solution to make it copper conducting. Okay, to make it copper conducting. Clean copper plates with sandpaper. Now rinse with water and dry them. Connect the copper plates to the terminals of the battery and immerse them in copper sulfate solution. As here you can see in the picture. Okay, allow the current to pass for about 15 minutes. Now remove the electrodes from the solution and look at them carefully. Do you find any difference in any of them? Yes, we can find the bubbles coming out from one place and it is accumulating in the other place. Okay, when electric current is passed through the copper sulfate solution dissociate, means it will break, dissociate means it will break copper and sulfate into copper and sulfate, two different, copper sulfate will break into two different, that is copper and sulfate. The free copper get drawn to the electrode connected to the negative terminal. As I said you, that is copper will go and attach to the negative terminal of the battery and get deposited on it. But what about the loss of copper from the solution? Okay, from the other electrode, a copper plate and equal amount of copper get dissolved in the solution. Okay, now in the solution it will take from one side, it is taking the copper and it is dissolving and it is going to the negative end. It breaks and it moves to the negative end of the negative end, that is the cathode. Okay, loss of copper from the solution is restored and the process continues. This means the copper gets transferred from one electrode to the other. Means it is coming from one side and it is going and depositing to the other electrode. Okay. The process of depositing a layer of any desired metal of one material by the means of electricity is called electroplating. This itself is electroplating. Means the copper from this rod, it is been dissolved in the water and it is going and attaching to the rod here which is there, which you can see the shiny thing here. The metal, on the metal the copper is being attached. Okay, pure copper to the cathode. As I said you, it has the ions, that is positive and negative ions. It will break down in the copper and sulfate, two different. And copper will go and attach to the negative, that is the cathode rays, and here you, all the copper will be there. Now from here it is taking the copper. From where the copper is getting? From this rod it is removing the copper and it is attaching to this. This process is known as electroplating. It is one of the most common applications of chemical effects of electric current. Okay, it is commonly used in many things. Electroplating is a very useful process. It is widely used in industries for coating metals, objects with a thin layer of different metals. Okay, nowadays we have heard 1 gram gold. 1 gram gold is also nothing but this electroplating things. Inside it will be different metal. Only the shining of the gold is given. Therefore, it is known as 1 gram gold. It is a process of electroplating. Okay, the layer of metal deposited has some desired properties which the metal of the object lacks. For example, not only that, the other example here is chromium plating. Chromium plating is done on objects such as car parts, bath taps, kitchen gas burners, bicycle handlebars, wheel rims and many other things which will be shining for few days. After few days it will become dull, means the upper part will be removed. Chromium has a shining appearance. It does not corrode. It resists scratches. However, chromium is expensive and it may not be economically to make the whole objects out of chromium. Why they are not making full with the chromium or with the gold? Because chromium is expensive. Even the gold is expensive. Only for the shining they will use. Okay, inside will be the different material. Outside just to look it will be shiny. That is nothing but with the process of electroplating they are doing it. Why that metal is very expensive. Now here chromium is expensive. Therefore inside will be the different materials, different metals. On the top for the shiny and soft surface we use the chromium. Even the bath inside in the bathroom we can see the taps are shining. Yes or no? That is because of the chromium which is present outside. So the object is made for a cheaper metal and only a coating of chromium over it is deposited. Jewelry maker electroplate silver and gold on less expensive metals. These ornaments have the appearance of silver or gold but are much less expensive. Okay, even the gold is more expensive. Therefore the plating thing, 1 gram gold, they will take and use it. Tin cans used for sorting food are made up of electroplating tin into iron. Even here the electroplating is done for the tins. The food we eat, it will be stored in that. Tin is less reactive than iron. Thus food does not come into contact with iron and is protected from getting spoiled. You know iron will get rust. Yes, food items may spoil. Therefore what they do? They do electroplating for the tins and then it will not rust, it will not spoil. Then they will store the food items in it. Iron is used in bridges and automobiles to provide strength. However, iron tends to corrode and rust. So, a coating of zinc is deposited on iron to protect it from corrosion and formation of rust. Not only there, even in the factories, they use so many metal items, that is iron items. Iron, you know, it has a tendency to rust and corrode. To stop that, this electroplating process will be used. And what is the metal which is used on iron? That is the zinc. Okay, zinc is deposited on the iron like a coating so that it should not do corrosions or rusting here. In the electroplating factories, the disposal of the used conducting solution is a major concern. It is a polluting waste and there are specific disposal guidelines to protect the environment. In this, the factory people will misuse and they will pollute the air. Instead, we have to take care of polluting this. Electroplating is good, but the factory people will pollute this waste into the water. We should take the proper guidelines to protect our environment. This completes the chapter. You have to complete the exercise in the textbook and all the question answers in your classwork. Thank you.